If you out there in the streets and you looking for me, when you find me, tell me, I said I've been looking for me. If you out there in the streets and you looking for me, when you find me, tell me, I said I've been looking for me.
Hey, what's up? Welcome back to Chilling with Akiris Got Game. You know what I'm saying? I got my nigga Monquay, you feel me, right here.
Monquay up in this thing, you know what's going on. You don't know the name, then you can't explain. Tell them, Mar Davis.
PC game, you know how it is. I'm playing.
God damn, bro. I swear to God, I be trying to be the normal one in this world, and you always keep saying it.
I had to say it, bro.
All right.
Shit, how y'all doing today? You feel me? You know what I'm saying? I hope y'all been safe and, you know, all of that. And without further ado, I'm going to pass it off to Monquay. You feel me? I'm going to let you start it off, bro.
Start it off? All right. So, let me ask everyone of y'all a question. How you will feel like love is affected somehow, but you don't know where the love is affected into, like, the conflicts and all that, or how you can't find the right person or this and that? Let me tell you what it is. Social.
And why do you say that's social right media?
I say in social media because you know how you with your... Now, this is real because social media projects the, you know, the be kind of right there. It's like right there. When you open your social right media, you're going to see right somebody in a plane or, you know, have their own car and all that. Sometimes you can find that right. You can find the right one. Trust, you can find the right one who be like, oh, that ain't. But you got some folks that who is single, especially single. They expect, some people expect, you know, they should be seeing this and seeing that. Now we got social media platform that you can goddamn go on the Kardashian, go on Kim page and she, you know, see a lot of shit like that. And, you know, social media affects, you know, love.
So, like, so what you're saying is that the reason social media affects is, like okay, like a famous person, right? They might have, like, all these riches and shit. And you know, I ain't gonna lie, you know, like, some females, they'll be like, you know, I need me a nigga that's gonna do this, this, and that.
Don't they?
The nigga ain't even got half that as, like, let's just say, like, Kanye or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, is that something you're trying to say, or like, what?
Well, it's like, okay, when you see people with a lot of stuff, and you know, and say, for example, you're trying to find a girl, not you, but if somebody, let me give you an example.
Okay,
but yeah, it's like, you know, just a person expect more than what they can get.
Oh,
yeah, like, so like when they look at a post, they be like, okay, he got a nice car, he got a who got it, or got him a car, or, you know, a Hellcat, skate pad.
Right.
And when a dude come up to the girl, you know, they talk to them and all that, and you know, they kind of, you know, some of them be, you know, straight with you, but some be salty because, you know, that, and they see you, you know, go back inside of your beatbox car that, you know, travels you to A to B, you know, you'll see that shit. And some women out here that expect more, because
expect more than what a guy can give them.
There you go. Like, it's some people out here, it's not even women, it's male too. Like, you expect this, but you gotta understand, social media is a platform, right? Reality is when you walk out that door.
Man, what? The world don't give a fuck about you as soon as you step your foot out the door.
Outside, I'm talking about 0.2.
Hell, you could be inside the fucking house.
Hell yeah, anything can happen in 0.3 seconds when you walk out that house and travel somewhere. Anything can happen.
Just like that damn white woman, but we ain't gonna mention that.
What white woman?
You know that? That white woman. Oh, I'm in the wrong house. Pop, 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 pop.
Oh.
You know what you was doing.
You in the wrong house.
But yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I see what you're saying, but like, and my thing is, I hate how everybody be hating on everybody just because of, like, well, not everybody, I hate how some people be hating on people just because of what they post on social media. Like,
yeah,
like, dude, right? He posted that he had a new Bugatti, right?
Mm-hmm.
And And excuse me, I fucking stuttered right then. And you know what I'm saying? It was a lot of niggas that was like, yo, you know what I'm saying? Why the fuck he got that? I'm the one that's supposed to have that, this. Mm. And I'm just like, listen, bro, that shit might not even be his. That shit might be rented, because niggas be faking on social media. Bro.
Like, because you heard about them women that, you know, they went to a studio and the seats was airport seats. So, like, they replaced it, you know, regular rolling chairs with airport seats. So, it was women who took pictures on them seats, making it seem like they was on a private jet. So, yeah, everything.
They did the damn Bow Wow challenge.
They did. They put that hoe back in the hashtag trending spot.
But
real, like, folks who hate real, that's the one thing I discourage anybody from doing. Not discourage, what the fuck I said. Yeah, whatever the fuck that is. But, I mean, don't never hate. Participate.
Yeah, you're right.
Never hate, participate. You know, never hate the gangster, hate the player.
You are so right. Don't hate. What you said? Don't hate.
Don't hate the gangster. Hate the player.
Right. Right.
Don't do that. That's
right.
Salty. We don't need.
Yeah. I'm not salty, bro. You feel me? Like,
no.
All love. It's all love. You know what I'm saying?
That's all it is. You know, I love this. I am, bro. I love giving positive energy. Like my sister, I hate me and her be going back and forth because I be trying to tell her right, and she don't want to listen.
What's going on with y'all, man? Like, what be going on with y'all?
You know, it's just siblings. Everybody have that one sibling that, you know, you try to teach them, because especially me, you know, I'm the oldest one and maturest. So, of course, I'm trying to give her life. Path, so she won't take it wrong. You know, sometimes when I tell her that shit, she be feeling like I'm talking to her wrong. But that's how every baby sister.
Like, you try to give a good advice and she take it the wrong way.
She take it the wrong way. Like I told her, she got scared because, you know, we just got in a wreck, so she got paranoid and we was on the road and, you know, the middle lane. So it was a car. You know, he left out the building and hit the middle lane. My sister got scared and she thought he was about to hit her, so she pressed the brake in the middle of the road. So I told her, I said, don't do that. I said, you can't do that. And she said, I'm not finna get hit. I said, you're not fence to, you know. The car wasn't even about to hit you, you know. He knew what he was doing. You had to still keep going. You know, she got paranoid and all that stuff. You know, I told her, and she over there don't want to listen. So I just said, look, I give up. You know, I tried to, you know, help it. You don't want to listen.
Some people that don't want help themselves. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And let me tell you something about me. Like I said, I love giving positive feedback to anybody.
Yeah, you gotta stay positive. Like you really do gotta stay positive, because a lot of bullshit will happen, like out of life, like nowhere, bro. Like, you feel me? You just got to, bro. I know I'm stuttering, but you know what I'm saying? Like, it's something, like, my bad, y'all. Like, I'm sorry. Like, something just happened a little earlier today. I'm trying to stay positive, like Monquay is telling me. But, my bad, bro. I ain't mean to cut you off. Go ahead.
No, you good. Shit. I like intakes. But, like I said, you know, positive. You got to always stay positive. You can't hate the next person when you can do the same thing. One thing I learned was, like, if you love something, what you do, like, I've been starting this. Like I said, you remember I kept telling you about I'm watching these videos.
Uh-huh.
I'm constantly watching. You know, I'm learning, like, investments and I'm learning about investment, flipping property, you know, flipping landscape,
right?
Like, real estate, stock market. I'm like dead ass serious. I can tell you some shit right now. I mean, peep you on game for a beginner. Like, I'm a beginner still, but I can peep you with the beginner shit. And then, you know, when shit go like that, shit, your stock go up and all. Like, me, I'm learning self love now. That's what everybody need to do at the end of this podcast, for real. That's self-love.
Hell
like,
yeah, boy.
What Akira said, self-love. That hate why you would...
Oh, no, that was actually you, man, that told me that.
Oh, well, you know, still, you know, it still tie in with self-love. Cause
yeah, you're right.
You can't hate nobody else when you the person in your body. You can't just be like, okay, he got a nice-ass car. Fuck that nigga. you know, like he got a nice ass car. I don't like that nigga. It's folks out here that's like that.
Yeah, you right.
But at the end, like self love, like love yourself. Only person who wakes up is you, and only person who go to sleep is you. Next day, you know. So, like I said, I've been watching these videos just learning. Like, I'm learning. Even while I'm, you know, unemployed, I'm learning, you know. Because I know when I step back in that workforce, you get what?
Regardless of having a job or not, you feel me? It's an ongoing thing.
Yeah. I don't know, yo. Yep. And then plus, in this wreck, you know, did push me back. So, yeah, the wreck pushed me back quick. So, you know.
Right. I got you.
I'm telling you, bro. Huh?
Oh no, go ahead.
Oh yeah, like ever since that, man, I'm telling you, ever since me and Akira had a one-on-one conversation, you know, and I was telling him about my problems, which, you know, that's real nigga shit, you know, when somebody can listen to something that, you know, that you can't, cause sometimes you can't hold shit in, like that, like I'm saying, self-love, you gotta tell some people, cause I didn't even know I had, you know, anxiety and shit, like, you know, that shit kind of, you know, fucked with me, especially at an older age, I knew I had anxiety, so, you know,
anxiety is not a good thing.
So I had to, you know, talk to Akira and tell him, you know, try to that, because that's one thing that they told me about self-love. You gotta talk to somebody and see what's their point of view about you, you know. You gotta see their point of view about you, because when you around the same people that say the same downgrading shit about you and then say they love you at the end of the day, you gotta find somebody else who can tell you who you really is instead of hearing people who say they love you and next minute get mad and shit. So, you know, self-love.
Yeah, self, and that's a good day, man. And that's like, you know, this is only part one of the podcast, but like that was a good place to stop it right there, man. Like, feel me? Like, hell yeah.
Appreciate that. Cause I had to, you know, put my realness in a sec, you know, I had to put the real Marquay in this
job. Oh yeah, man, this podcast is all about being real, bro. It's all being about real. Being real. So yeah,
you know, somebody had this probably, you know, some, of course, they say 4.2 million got anxiety. You know, 4.2 million got anxiety, so shit, you know, that's a come and go type job too, sometimes. So yeah, I had to tell you that shit. It's some folks out here that's struggling, and I just started. Like, this is me starting. Imagine the folks who've been had that, and you know, right. Being like, because you said you had, right?
I had what?
Anxiety.
I've been struggling with anxiety my whole life.
See, and I just started, you know? So I gotta, you know, listen to folks who've been in that place so they can tell me, you know, whether or not, you know, you good or not. You straight or not, you know. Don't overthink yourself. You know,
can't,
you.
Man.
You gotta be you. That's what I'm doing, bro. I'm being my best, greatest player. I'm being my best player.
Yeah. You gotta be your biggest supporter, bro.
Biggest.
Yeah. And especially with that, is there anything else you wanted to say?
Before
we end it?
Nah. I already said, what's got to be told. Especially with that hater shit. Don't hate.
Don't hate.
You got to participate. Never hate. Participate and relate.
Man,
you can't. And one thing at the end, you can't hate the player.
Hate the game.
Hate the game. I put it on the game. Fuck it.
Hell no. Listen, I appreciate you. I appreciate, you know, you coming on, man. You know what I'm saying? And, well, this is just part one, but you feel me? I appreciate you doing this real quick. I hope you be safe, you and your family and all that. And to the people who actually listen, I'm still somewhat surprised by that. But, like, people actually listen to my podcast. For the people who listen, I hope y'all safe. I hope y'all be easy. And y'all, you know what I'm saying? Y'all be good.
Yep, same way, same over here. Y'all be good and learn self-love, you know. And if you trying to chase something, put in, you know, learning about that, you know. That's one thing you got to do, just learn. But self-love at the beginning, that's first step. Self-love, then when you find that self-love, conquer.
Yeah, yeah. Shit.
Well, shit, let's end. I'm gonna end it right here. Y'all, you be easy, bro.
All right, bro.
All right.